Hello everyone. I would like to welcome you all to our presentation. I'm really happy to be here today and have the opportunity to interact with many valuable partners, get to know to new people, and just a quick note, this presentation will be in English because of our neighbors, the honor country, Bulgaria. We have guests from there, so we would like to incorporate them and make everyone understand. My name is Vicky Kotula. I'm the Research and Innovation Manager of Renel. Our goal today will be to let you know about us, who we are, what we do, have a real quick look at net zero buildings. Why are they important? What exactly are they? And what can we do towards that direction? And present some of our key solutions regarding the net zero buildings. So here you can see the table of content. We will start with a real quick introduction and presentation of the company. We will proceed with the problem and the definitions and the benefits of net zero buildings, present our approach and our key solutions, and get to the real point, the conclusion. What should we do? Let's start with Renel. You can hear the name, Renel Energy and Power Engineering, and of course you start to realize that energy engineering, okay, what does that company do? We are a private company, a technical company, an SME, based here in Thessaloniki. Our focus is in the sector of energy. The company was established in 2009, and since then we try and provide all the solutions regarding to the sector of energy and electromechanical. So here, we provide innovation is our value, holistic solutions, turnkey solutions for energy and electromechanical projects and services. We emphasize in sectors such as industry, the building sector, the energy sector, and the sector of research, which is actually my department. We implement cost-effective solutions, and we try to promote business vision regarding resilience and efficiency. Our main points of interest, of course, this list is indicative. As I told you, anything related to energy is what we do and what we support. But let's mention just a few things regarding that. Energy solutions and energy upgrades. Net zero and positive energy buildings, building renovations, deep renovations, energy monitoring systems, combined heat and power systems, smart cities, industry 4.0, energy communities, coaching, formation and management of them, rest development, on-grid, off-grid, hybrid solar energy stations, the charging stations. We are really into e-mobility and we support innovation in that sector. Smart charging station and turnkey carport solutions. The automatic aerial inspection using drones. We have incorporated a new sector in the company, CO2, and we try to use drones for innovative solutions, mainly for inspections, such as inspections of photovoltaic parks and aerial power grids. Our departments, of course, we have the accounting department, the R&D, my department, the sales and marketing, the renewable energy sources development and electromobility department, and the EPC, engineering, procurement, construction, and maintenance department, which is actually our core business right now. Our employees, as you can see in the graph, we are, the majority of us are electrical engineers, and we also have a team combined of mechanical engineers, civil engineers, and economists. 1/3 of our employees are women, and the other 2/3 are male. And now that you have a pretty solid understanding of who we are and have gotten to know what we do, let's start with the problem. It's actually a serious one. It's that what we face nowadays, and we should all have quite give the importance it needs. We will talk today about the building sector, as I have mentioned before. The problem is that this sector, the building sector, accounts for a very significant portion of global energy consumption and greenhouse gas emissions. If we want to talk with numbers, you can see that in the EU, the building sector is responsible for 40% of our energy consumption and 36% of greenhouse gas emissions, which is really high, and it's something we have to tackle and take into consideration. The current practices in the building construction and operation contribute to climate change and environmental degradation. As you can understand, what we do now is not really effective, so we have to start thinking about how we can change this. The facts and the numbers that I have mentioned can highlight the urgent need for sustainable and energy-efficient building solutions. We know the problem, we have understand the problem, and now we have to think about the solutions, about the next steps. First of all, what is a zero energy building? Because we hear this term all the time, ZEB, zero energy building, or maybe even positive energy building, but maybe we aren't aware of what exactly this means. What do we mean by the term zero energy building? It's actually a building that has a very high energy performance. That's one key point. And the other one is that the nearly zero or the very low amount of energy that this building needs should, at least, be covered by renewable energy sources that maybe be on-site or nearby produced. Of course, it can be solar energy, geothermal energy, wind energy, but the main fact is that we have a high energy performance and the integration of renewable energy sources. Let's move on to the main aspects of the zero energy building. What are some solutions? What are some key points that we will take into consideration when we think about the zero energy building? What does it conclude in the final? The first one is a building envelope with enhanced insulation. It's the first step. We have to insulate our building. We have to make it concrete as the first step. Next, we have the integration of renewable energy sources that we mentioned earlier. It can be, again, solar, wind, geothermal energy. The energy monitoring and management systems are also very important, very crucial. We will talk about it later regarding our solutions on that. A near zero energy building or a positive energy building also has efficient lighting, LED lighting, and efficient HVAC systems. Of course, another aspect we could take into consideration is the smart water management. And of course, since we are in an exhibition about circular economy, we will take into consideration the sustainable and locally sourced materials. Now, anyone could ask, okay, I know now what are the zero energy buildings, but why should I upgrade my building to promote it to zero energy building? What are the benefits for me or even for society? The benefits are both environmental and economic. So it's something that we should really take into consideration and proceed with these solutions. If we want to analyze a bit more about the benefits, of course, here are only some of those, and I can think of many, many more. I'm sure that you can also do that. But the first one that's really important for an average user is the reduction of energy costs, because they are more efficient, the energy zero energy buildings. They produce their own energy with renewable energies, so we can reduce our costs. On top of that, they improve indoor air quality. They promote healthier living and working environments. So we should incorporate solutions for zero energy buildings in both residential and non-residential buildings. On top of that, they increase property value. It's a common known sense that the zero energy, or even better, the positive energy buildings have an increased value in the market. And of course, these buildings help us to meet our sustainability goals. Our approach on this matter. At Renel, we offer innovative solutions for net zero and positive energy buildings. We believe in a future that is more green, more smart, more resilient, so we work towards that direction. By harnessing the power of sustainable technologies, we can pave the way for a greener and more cost-effective future. Here today I will present four of our key solutions. Indicative solutions, again, we can and we will have the opportunity to talk at our booth for even more solutions and turnkey solutions. But let's say today some basic principles. The first one will be the carport solution, the solar facade, the energy communities, and the energy and asset manager. The first solution, the solar facade. It's a way to unlock sustainable energy. What are solar facades? It's a solution that we can incorporate in the exterior of our building. In a simple word, it's more surface to produce energy. We go beyond the mainstream solution of putting photovoltaics on the roof of a building, and we can produce even more energy with that. They are integrated into the building's exterior. The innovative fact and what's important and really appealing is that this solution is ad hoc. You can prefabricate units and in various sizes, various shapes. It's not a solution that doesn't have options. You can do according to the building topology, whatever suits the building and the client's needs. So it's fully customizable, and we can go to the building, evaluate its needs, its topology, and then proceed with the design and our proposal regarding the solar facade. It's easy to install. It doesn't need extensive renovation processes or time-consuming processes. So it's actually very convenient. Its other real innovative aspect that distinguishes the solar facade from an average facade is the fact that it can incorporate other solutions, other features inside it, such as insulation and ventilation. This facade has a thickness, and inside that we can put insulation and we can incorporate the ventilation systems. So it's like a three-in-one package. Of course, inside it we can also put and incorporate sensors and smart monitoring systems in order to make the facade smart and proceed with its optimal control and performance. And for the architects that are watching us, it's an aesthetically pleasing design that really complements your building's architecture. As I mentioned before, we can place it in various shapes and various sizes, so we can really have the result that we're aiming for. Moving on to the next solution, Another turnkey compact solution is our carport. Here, what we have is an utilization of outdoor parking space, enhanced with production of green energy. So we can put it in parking spots. This has a really nice effect on malls or large hotels or in the industry sector, where we have large areas that we can cover with this shield, with this carport. It has multiple benefits. On top of everything is that it has an effective protection of vehicles from sun, rain, heavy snowfall. That's an average kiosk, you might say, but with this one, we can produce the clean energy. It's a concrete construction with support columns. It's really concrete and safe. You can incorporate LED lighting to make it more beautiful. And of course, you can expand it and make it as large as you wish. There is no limit in that. The main feature that you have to keep in mind is that it gives us extra space to put photovoltaics, while also having a spot to park our cars. It also increases the value of your building, especially in hotels, where you can have your client's car protected and also produce your energy for the building. The energy community is real important. It's actually a movement towards a greener future, a greener tomorrow. What are energy communities? They are local urban cooperatives created for promoting citizen participation in the energy sector. So it's really important for all of us. Through energy communities, all the citizens can participate as individuals or as legal entities, and they can engage in energy production. So it's something we can all do. At Renel, we definitely recognize the value of the energy communities, and we want to support them and help towards that direction. And we have dedicated coaching services. These services include support for their establishment and their operation as well. The Energy and Asset Manager, it's a tool, it's a state-of-the-art cloud solution in order to optimize our energy users. That's its main benefit. It can integrate energy and asset management in a single dashboard. It's really user-friendly, easy to use, and the main point is that how can I decrease my energy consumption if I don't know what I consume? The first step is to know my profile, my consumption profile, my energy profile. So I will have to monitor and view as a first step exactly where I consume, when I consume more. After I have my profile set and I know all the statistics, all the numbers, I can proceed with the management and with the optimal solutions to decrease my energy consumption. But I can do that until I know what and exactly when I consume. So this system allows us to create an energy profile, have a totally clear understanding of our consumptions, and we can view, manage, and optimize the building system from anywhere and at any time. This tool provides insight that will help us minimize cost and risk and maximize performance and safety across our operations. So the conclusion and what we should keep from this presentation is that we should embrace the power of sustainable building practices, and we should create a greener future. We know the problem, we have an understanding of the solutions, so we will have to just take the next step and start incorporating these solutions in our buildings. Of course, we can discuss more of these solutions and even more at our booth, CO3, and we are always open to discussions and explaining whatever you need. We can always keep in touch. You can see here my email. Feel free to contact me at any time for new collaborations or new questions that you might have. Thank you very much.